science is this amazingly cool tool that lets you be curious about the world and ask questions about how it works and then try to find answers. If scientists do that by themselves and they don't let anyone know what their answers are, the people in the world are not wiser for it. My name is Laura Snider. I'm the senior science writer here at the University Corporation for Atmospheric Research. Our scientists here study the Earth system. And along with that is how actions we may be taking as a society impact that Earth system and what that Earth system might look like in the future. It's important to communicate that to people so that people understand how the choices we make as a society might impact our future. Typically, I start the day checking in on our social media channels. I like to look at Twitter, see what stories we've written, people are talking about, what people are interested in. And then my day is usually about talking to scientists, trying to understand some of the science that's going on here, and then trying to write about it in a way that hopefully anyone can understand and find interesting. My undergraduate degree from Virginia Tech is in environmental science. And then afterwards, I spent a few years teaching field science classes to middle schoolers and also outdoor education. I really enjoyed the process of explaining to them and helping them understand how the science worked. So I decided that I would go back to school in journalism, and then after that I became a reporter at the Daily Camera newspaper, and I went to the University of Colorado, Boulder to be a science writer, and then I came here to UCAR. So when I was an undergraduate, I just took science, and I had one semester of freshman English that I had to take, and I needed the skills to learn how to write clearly and interestingly and compellingly. You know, we all have to write in our lives, but I think writing, especially about complex topics, takes a lot of practice and I needed a lot of guidance. Internships are key. If you can write or film or illustrate science in a way that people can understand and you can show that to people, then they'll want you to work for them. I can't stress enough how important it is to get out there and do the work, to do the internship, to get your hands dirty, to practice it with someone that can be a mentor and that can help you get better. So I might tell my younger self or somebody else who's just starting college that you don't need to know exactly what you're going to do your first year. But every step along the way, you get more information, you learn about yourself, what you're good at, what you're like, and then you take the next step, and it all leads somewhere in the end. Science communication is the really fun job. It allows you to be curious and to learn about a lot of different things. One of my favorite things about my job is that I'm always learning something new.